Welcome back, students. Let's see another topic, that is amino acids. Now amino acids are the building blocks of proteins. That means proteins are made up of amino acids. These amino acids have carboxylic acid group, that is this one, amino group, that is this one, that is NH2. Next is the side group of R, which gives a unique characteristics, which is this one as well as one hydroxyl group. Okay, so this is the main side R group which makes different amino acids. For example, here we can see if here only one hydrogen atom is attached, this amino acid becomes glycine. If methyl group is attached to this R, it becomes alanine. So glycine and alanine are the types of amino acids. Sorry, are the examples of amino acids. But basically there are two types of amino acids. First is nonpolar and polar. Nonpolar can be R attached with the R group has hydroxyl, methyl, alkyl groups or the aromatic groups, while polar groups have like the alcoholic group or the amino group. Now polar acidic will have CH2, COOH or COOH, and polar basic will have this one. Now what are the essential amino acids? There are basically 10 amino acids which are not synthesized by the body, like arginine, histidine, leucine, lysine, these many, which are obtained from the diet. These amino acids are basically present in the dietary products, and one more missing grain are present in the vegetables. Now these amino acids are linked by the amide, or you can say the peptide bonds. Now these glycine, lysine, here you can say phenylalanine, or are attached. Okay, so these amino acids make up a protein, right, and they are attached with the specific bonds. This specific bond is called as peptide bonds. So this become glycyl, lysyl, phenylalanine, arginine, serine. Okay, so students, in this session we have seen about the amino acid and peptide bond. In further session we will look over other biomolecules. Thank you.